Greetings. I think it is important, brother, to actually discuss topics without assumptions. We both accept that God exists and He is the maker of heaven and earth. The chasm that divides us, brother, is which path to take and which oath to make. And your thinking is based on an assumption that I think clouds your perception. Let's take a look at this, brother, and hopefully you'll see what I mean. You follow Muhammad and the religion described by the Quran and the Hadiths. Your religion requires you to swear an oath called the Shahada. You must say, La ilaha illa Allah wa Muhammad Rasulullah. There is no God but Allah. But that is not the whole oath you must make, brother. You must also swear to a certain man. You must say, Wa Muhammad Rasulullah, and Muhammad is the prophet of Allah. That is something very different from what the prophets of Yahweh taught, brother. The prophets of Yahweh, specifically Prophet Moses, taught the Shema. Deuteronomy 6:4. Shema Yisrael, Yahweh Eloheinu, Yahweh Echad. Hear, O Israel, Jehovah our God is one Jehovah. And that is where the oath of the Shema ends, brother. Prophet Moses did not try to make men swear to follow himself. I want you to really understand that point, brother. Moses did not make Israel swear that Moses is the prophet of Yahweh. And brother, with over 40 prophets sent by God over 3,000 years, not one ever made Israel swear that the prophet was a prophet of Yahweh. The point, brother, is that only God is to be worshipped and obeyed. This is the message of the prophets. But that is not the message of Muhammad. The message of Muhammad is that you must obey Muhammad. I can already hear you shouting, brother. No, 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 Muhammad said we must obey Allah. Okay, I understand. These are the thoughts you are taught, brother. But have you ever thought about them, my friend? Muhammad says you must obey Allah. That's what you tell me. Fair enough. For discussion, let's assume one only obeys Allah. It is reasonable to ask, how can one obey Allah? Does Allah speak to you or anyone in Islam? If you are honest, you must say no. If Allah speaks to you, brother, and you repeat His words, you are a prophet, brother. And that creates problems for Islam that I won't address in this video, brother. Does Allah live in you? I think an honest Islamic answer must be no, Allah cannot enter His creation. But that does not fit with the concept that Allah guides you, does it? How can Allah guide you when He cannot communicate with you? Perhaps like a hockey player guides a puck with a stick? An arbitrary external poke or tap to change your direction, followed by a reflexive inshallah. So then it bears repeating, how can one obey Allah? And the answer must be, one obeys Allah by obeying Muhammad. No, 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 Muhammad said we must obey Allah. I know this is hard for you to grasp, brother. Allah does not speak to you. Allah does not live in you. Therefore, the only way you can know what Allah commands is to obey someone else who claims Allah does speak to them for you. And in fact, this is what Muhammad claimed. I challenge you, brother, to look up the following ayat. Surah 480. He who obeys the messenger has in effect obeyed Allah. That's the Muntakab translation. If you obey Muhammad, brother, Muhammad said, you are obeying Allah. That makes Muhammad equal with Allah, brother. This is a very hard reality for you to understand and harder to accept. Any man who says, you cannot obey Allah unless you obey me, has just given themselves the same authority as Almighty God. You really need to understand this, brother, to understand why Islam is a false path. Of this, there can be no doubt, brother. Muhammad established a religion that made himself equal with the deity Allah that Muhammad claimed to speak for. He who obeys the messenger has in effect obeyed Allah. There was a children's game we played when I was young. The game is called Simon Says. In the game, one child is designated as Simon. He's like the prophet. Simon gives instructions to the other children. Stand on one leg. Hop three times. And here is what makes the game a game. The players must only obey commands started with Simon Says. Simon Says, stand on one leg. Simon Says, hop three times. If Simon the leader does not say Simon Says, you must not obey the command. Well, in the game of Islam, brother, Muhammad has abolished the need to say Allah says. He who obeys the messenger has in effect obeyed Allah. If Muhammad gives you a command, you must obey. Muhammad does not need to say Allah says. If you disobey Muhammad, you have disobeyed Allah. There is no prophet in the Torah or Bible who created this situation, brother. Now I understand you will try to think around this issue, my friend. Your answer will have to be that you do not pray to Muhammad. But that point is irrelevant to the problem I have described, brother. Muhammad has established himself as co-commander with Allah. Allah says, obey Muhammad. But more precisely, Muhammad says, Allah says, obey Muhammad. I hope you can understand this, brother. I can explain it to you, but I cannot understand it for you. Muhammad says, Allah says, obey Muhammad. That is nothing more than a man saying that God said, you must obey that man. That can best be described as a self-serving statement. How can a man give himself the authority of a god? That man can claim that the Allah said to obey that man. Consider this example. Texas says, Allah says you must obey Tex. So now you must obey me because Allah said you must obey Tex. Or do you think I just made that up for this example? Allah said you must obey Tex. Would that be believable to you? Hopefully not. Because it is an example. I am not claiming Allah said that. The point of the example is to give you something concrete to think about. Do not assume Muhammad spoke the truth when Muhammad claimed Allah said you must obey Muhammad. That is an assumption, and it would be a wrong assumption, brother. It would be an assumption that would cause you to accept a self-serving, manipulative statement. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.